Nature can be both tranquil and very noisy. But what about sounds from beyond the Earth's atmosphere, space? Despite what you read in fiction books or see in science fiction movies, you can't truly hear any sound in space. Space is a vacuum, and the lack of air prevents sound from traveling through space. But what if we discovered a way to listen to the stars, particularly the sun? Consider the possibility that sound can travel across space in the same way it does through the Earth's atmosphere. The sun would cease to be a silent ball of fire in the sky. Instead, it would be a never-ending white noise machine that blared like a rock concert throughout the day. The sun is unbelievably loud, even if we cannot hear it from Earth. It's extremely loud and downright deafening. This is due to the fact that the sun, while appearing smooth and tranquil from Earth, is actually a whirlwind of superheated plasma. The nuclear processes that provide energy to a star result in the constant rising and falling of convection cells of superheated gas across its surface. There are around a million of these on our sun at any given time. Suppose the convection cells are almost the size of Texas, and that they emerge from beneath the surface, burning out and sinking all within 5 minutes. That would be an extremely violent operation and tremendously noisy. Each of these convection cells produces approximately 100 to 300 watts of sound energy per square meter, which is comparable to a police siren. In addition, since the sun's surface area is around 10,000 times that of Earth, that would be the equivalent of 10,000 Earths covered in police sirens, all blaring. Since the Earth is 92 million miles from the sun, the sound would be muffled by the time it reached Earth. The sun's roar on Earth is estimated to be roughly 100 decibels, which is slightly softer than speakers at a rock concert. Of course, this is during the day. During the night, the roar would fade as we turn away from the sun. The roar would be sort of dull because the sound waves coming to Earth would be made up of so many various frequencies. But there are a few things that need to be overlooked in order to create a world where the sun can be heard. Of course, there's the aspect of the vacuum of space, but there's also the fact that sound waves steepen as they travel across long distances. This means that, like ocean waves, they will eventually break and crash against each other. In this case, even if sound could travel through space, the waves would never leave the sun's atmosphere or corona. They'd implode instead as shock waves, disintegrating into heat. And if we apply the experiment to the realm of biology, an audible sun could have obliterated the concept of hearing altogether. Any species that developed in a world where there was a constant roar may have completely different hearing needs. Indeed, species in this fictitious world may never have evolved the ability to perceive sound, since they could never make out any sounds at all. It's safe to say that we wouldn't be able to hear anything in such a hypothetical scenario. For more than two decades, data from ESA and NASA's Solar and Heliospheric Observatory, SOHO, has captured the sun's natural vibrations and provided scientists with a visual representation of the dynamic movement of the sun's atmosphere. Since there are no simple methods or microscopes to zoom into the sun, scientists look inside the sun through its vibrations. Using data from the observatory, they can now hear the sun's movement, including all its waves, loops, and eruptions with their own ears. They can use this sound to analyze complex motions inside the sun, such as solar flares and coronal mass ejections. Overall, it's best the sun's uproar remains locked away by the emptiness of space, because it would render us deaf. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.